Liz just started going back to work.
Pretty much just taking over the front of the house and to expand.
My answer is yes. Ed is trying to work on his relationship with his mom.
Just run through my house and talk to me.
I thought you were mad at me. I don't feel like I'm being heard.
Would you shut up?
I'm just tired of people being mad at me. I'm just not ready to get married.
Someone the other day asked me if Big Ed wears a fat suit and goes to a wedding, is it just called a suit? I didn't have the answer for that. But what I do have the answer for is that this is the Big Ed finale on Happily Ever After, 90 Day Fiancé. This is finally the episode where Liz and Big Ed get married? Or something happens. Because something has to happen. Because this is the last episode. And the next time we see them is at the tell-all. And what could they possibly be telling if they're not married or divorced or something? I've been waiting this whole series for something to happen. Honestly, if this man just exploded, I'd at least have been like, oh, okay. I've been waiting for something, and I'm hoping that today is that thing. Today, we're gonna look at the final episode. Spoiler alert, he doesn't want to get married. Okay, before we start, please do consider subscribing. We're on our way to 600,000 big babies, which is a lot of people at my daycare company. Also, follow me at 16leo_ on my Instagram. That way you can message me for new ideas and new series. Thank you for everyone who's made it into the new year with me. I hope that you're excited for a brand new year of Leo content. Just so excited to see Big Ed in the new year. So glad that he's here in the new year with me, because that's my favorite part of the new year. It's just Big Ed.
Bye, doggies. Liz just started going back to work and working.
Ah, yes. So as we catch up with the series, the final thing that we had last time was Big Ed is having to deal with Liz going back to work. And she's going back to work to support herself and her child, which she has. Everyone forgets that she has a kid. She's also been married and divorced 3 times. Sorry, but she has. Big Ed has no neck and looks like a ball. So if you've caught up on that, you know everything you need to know about the series. And if you don't think he looks like a ball, look at him in black. They say black is slimming.
Before a breakup that we, all she did was work.
Back to Big Ed content. And he is clearly still the same man that he always was. All she did was work. She keeps working and making money and trying to be an independent person. I'm trying to make a mind. I'm trying to control her. Big Ed has a problem with control and also self-control, evidently. But this man is a control freak. He needs to know where Liz is at all times. That's why he does things like accuse her of being a lesbian, because he sees her with another girl. If Big Ed saw her with a rock, he would think it's The Rock. He's just not that type of person to trust and have faith and not exercise his demons onto this poor, poor girl. I know she's got her own issues, but it's Big Ed.
And then come home late. I do sort of feel that Liz is putting herself first.
Yeah, well, she should. I'm sorry. New year, new me. Which she should, you bitch. What are you talking about? If in a relationship, it's not like you put the other person first the whole time. In order to prosper and grow, you gotta put yourself first in some aspects. It's not every aspect. This woman clearly loves you enough to stay with you. I mean, no disrespect, Big Ed, but like, you look like a frog a little bit. And I don't know how you even pound her. I'm sorry, but I don't. But the fact that she's not only okay with this, seems to be in love with you despite the fact that you are a literal bowling ball, that should give you a clear indication that even though she's putting some things first, she's clearly putting your pee-pee in her life. So she must love you. Also, if we pause right here, look at his fupa. Look at that underneath fupa. That is a cultivated mass right there. That's a black hole.
And our relationship.
God damn, shirts. Someone needs to make shirts that have like a boulder shape. Do you know what I mean? Like the shirt goes like this and it just allows for the man's gut to sit properly without it sticking out like that, because the shirt was never made to be stretched out like that. That shirt is getting tortured by this man's flesh. So they need to work on new shirts for people with fupa like that.
I'm realizing that I have to do the same thing.
Edward!
So Big Ed realizes that Liz is putting herself first by working full time. Thus, Big Ed says that he's going to put himself first, and he meets none other than his lover. Sorry, his mother.
Oh, Mom, Jesus. Since my trip to Arkansas, I've been wanting to reach out to my mom. It's my first time seeing my mom in...
Oh my god. It's his first time seeing his mom and he looks just as confused as the first time he sees anyone. Is that what you always look like? Were you always this color? Oh my god.
Over a year. She made her mind up at that point that...
She's looking back at him like... Are you my son? What, did I leave you in a bowling alley? What the fuck? What?
I've been waiting for you to come back. It's been a long time. It's been a worrisome time. This is so heartbreaking to me, what's going on in a year.
So, for anybody who doesn't know and hasn't kept up, Big Ed and his mother have become estranged due to the relationship he has with Liz. His mom does not think Liz is right for him, and Big Ed is trying to fight for her to be in his life, which is honestly pretty sad. Because regardless of if they break up a million times or not, it is at the end of the day this man's decision to be with a woman he loves. And usually, and hopefully, the family will support you. Despite their reservations, family should still support you no matter what. And so I do genuinely feel sorry that Big Ed has to fight so much just to be in this relationship. Because he loves Liz. And Liz loves him. It's not a good relationship. It's a hilarious one. There is love there. Amongst the other toxicities and many, many other things that go into that concoction they call love, there is love.
Ed was brokenhearted many, many times, and he came crying to me many times, and I think he thought it was love. I think it was more the seduction.
God, I don't want to hear about seducting. I don't want to hear about Big Ed getting seduced, you know? I don't want to hear about Big Ed getting seduced. You know what I mean, Mama Ed? I don't really need that in my life. I would like to not ever think about Big Ed in a big bed, getting his Big Ed given some big head. You know what I mean? No. Also, by the way, do you like the get up? This is from a video that is upcoming. Ugly Leo shirts are going to be a thing for a very limited time. Get yours while they're hot. Unless they're out now, in which case you should have got them.
When you love somebody,
you take a crap on them. I don't know why that came out of my mouth.
Why push everybody away? It doesn't make sense.
I had to push everybody out so I could listen to my own heart and what I wanted.
So, you know, if you look behind the stupid funniness of Big Ed saying stuff like, I had to listen to my own heart to really tell me what the hell it is. What he's really saying is that there was a lot of people giving him an opinion. And he is not the type of person to listen to himself despite what others say. With other people's opinions, Big Ed is easily influenced, and he had to really just silence everyone in order to think for himself, which is half sad and half, you know, clever that he did it.
The focus on my life right now is for you to be happy, son.
For the most part, I'm happy, but...
For the most part, but not the whole part.
I mean, no one's 100% happy, Mom.
That's true. You can't only be happy 40% of the time. Even 50% seems like you're pushing it. You should be happy most of the time, especially if this is the relationship you want and this is the person you want to marry. Ideally, the good should outweigh the bad. You know what I mean, Big Ed?
Liz and we still have our little tiffs.
Did you tell her about the time you called her a lesbian? I would love to see her opinion on that. Can you please say that I called my to-be wife a lesbian for no reason at all? Did you tell her that she said that you have a small dick? Can you tell your mom any of this information? I'd really love to see Norma's face be like, oh, give me another wine.
I'm happy, but we just, you know, we're not ready to get married.
You're not ready yet.
No.
Good for you.
God damn it. You ever say something like, hey, mom, I'm not ready to get married. And your mom's like, hell yeah. Shit. That's what I bet on. That's what I got $10 on him not getting married. Good work, son. You stay single, you like a Pringle, you little.
To my house and talk to me and just pour your heart out to me. Like,
every now and again the series actually reaches into my heartstrings. This is one of those moments. It's a tender moment between a mom and son, and the mom is saying, you need to come to me when you're feeling some sort of way. And you know, in any sense of the word, this is just heartbreaking that it even got to that point. So when I saw this, I was like, wow, you know, Big Ed's mom really cares about him. To have people in your life that love you that much, unequivocally, it's special. So, I hope that he understands that.
And Mom, I'm just tired of people being mad at me. I thought you were mad at me.
My God, you're my son, Pony.
Oh, by the way, she calls him Pony because she thinks he looks like a pony. I don't know what massacre must have happened in her life to think that this man looks like a pony. But if My Little Pony looked like Big Ed, it would have sold zero.
Do you want to see Liz?
I'm not ready for this situation. I just want you to be happy.
You get one mom in this world. It does give me hope.
Big Ed, every now and again, I just love the way he phrases things. You get one mom in this world. One opportunity. Are you gonna squander it? Or are you just gonna tell her that you don't want anything for dinner? You better lose your mom in the crowd and then scream out, where's my mom?
Now you're back. My last sheep is back.
Hey, baby.
Yeah, so that scene happens. Norma and Big Ed have rekindled themselves. Liz has a job. She's accepted it. Now they have to meet each other and talk about what's going to happen in their lives and in the future. They do this, of course, in the best place possible, the jacuzzi, where you will get to see Big Ed with his titties out.
You ready?
Young love. I hope you were eating something. So good.
Things have already been weird between Ed and I since I got offered partnership. Ed is trying to work on his relationship with his mom. This makes me nervous because...
That makes me nervous, man. I tell you, every time I see him without a shirt, they should issue a warning. Like, Big Ed's gonna enter without a shirt. Prepare yourself.
I know opinions and talks and stuff can get into Ed's head and wear him down. And I think that's a threat to our relationship.
Oh my God. This looks like a water funeral, man. What is this? We now pronounce this man dead at 8:46 p.m. in the jacuzzi. May he float in heaven, I guess. Like a turd. Right?
Today was good. It was very emotional. My mom basically said, look, I'm...
Talking about your mom while you're shirtless in a jacuzzi to your wife is the sexiest thing I've ever seen in my life. This is something special.
Every time I brought up your name, she wouldn't touch it. It was kind of funny.
Don't say that! If you don't have to say it, and it doesn't really make a difference, don't say it. You know, this girl was hitting on me, and she said she would suck me off if I was single. Anyway, I said, no thank you, I'll have a coffee. What? Why are you angry? What did I say? Don't say it! Liz is obviously not gonna feel happy if you say that. She has a tumultuous relationship with your mother anyway. Just make it worse, bro! What if Liz came and said one of the chefs was hitting on me? And then said, anyway, going back to work on Monday. Clearly you'd have some questions.
I can't move forward marrying Liz until I have my mom's support. But I may have to come to that realization that my mom may never accept Liz.
So that's, again, a tough position to be in. You don't want to choose between, is your mom going to be happy or is your wife going to be happy? Like, you know, those are two very important people in your life. And ideally you want, if you get married, your mom to turn up. But Big Ed is going to have to take a stand one way or another. And, you know, as future would have it, you'd like to make sure that you say, I'm going to get married, Mom, and I hope that you support me one way or another, because I'm going to do it. That's what I would do personally. I think everyone walks in their own way. I just don't think that someone should be controlling me. If they're my family, the best they should be doing is saying, I think this is that. And if I don't support you, I'm still going to support you in your decision, even though I don't agree with it. You'd hope for that.
We have a lot that we're taking on right now.
I'm going in to talk to the chef who owns the restaurant about the partnership.
So the next day, Liz goes to talk to the restaurant owner to get her promotion.
So obviously there would be more responsibilities, pretty much just taking over the front of the house, help me look for investors and to expand.
Damn, she started off as a waitress. This man's like, I want you to look for investors. I want you to expand the business. I want you to globalize this shit. Turn it into like McDonald's in about 2 weeks. Okay? I want a mascot who is a clown but sells burgers. I want it to be that confusing and still that global. Okay?
It would also mean a salary increase. I'm not asking for any money up front. You know, just sweat equity.
You're not asking for money. You just said you're going to give her a pay raise. Listen, bro, I'm not asking for money. I'm asking you to make my company bona fide, like, you know, big company, like franchise. I'm asking you to turn this shit into a Wendy's, dog. Okay?
My answer is yes.
That's great.
Yeah. Always in the past, I gave up my career plans for a man, but I'm still nervous to tell Ed about my decision.
I just want you to know, and this is something that I think anyone should probably know, you can be in a high-profile job and still have a beautiful, healthy relationship. It does not require so much effort in your job that you cannot actually maintain a relationship. And thinking that you have to choose between the two, to me, is stupid. Because I think you can very much balance the two. And should be able to, because that is how life works. You can't stop the job and then be like, well, now I'll be in a relationship. You could do both, and you probably have to. You have to put in a lot of work. I'm not saying relationships aren't work, and I'm not saying jobs aren't work. And it's probably easier just to do one. But if you're just in a relationship and you're not chasing your dreams, that sucks. And if you're just chasing your dreams and don't have someone to share the accolades and achievements with, it's pretty lonely there too. I know a lot of people are like, I gotta focus on myself. You can do both. Just know that. Like DJ Khaled said, know that.
Here's to a great future.
Yeah, that company is gonna fail. Sorry. Next time Big Ed and Liz have to have a conversation and she has to disclose to Big Ed that she is now the CEO of Fincontra. She's not the CEO. She just works as a manager now.
Why are you being so quiet?
Why are you being so weird? It took you like 20 seconds to drink a whatever the hell that was, and then you licked your lips round like that. That's weird, bro. You look like a kid that never grew up.
Talk to me.
Today, I just accept.
What are you doing? This is kind of weird couple. She's like, yes, I'm going to drink this like an alligator. Sorry, that was a turtle. I'm drunk.
I met with Chef, and I think it's a pretty good offer.
Wow, he's doing the thinking man pose. Can you imagine if that they did this as the thinking man pose? They'd run out of marble, bro. What the hell, bro?
I don't have to put any money in to become partner. I'll be getting a raise.
So Liz is really scared that Big Ed and his controlling nature are going to hear this and hear that she took the promotion without even consulting him and say something bad. Big Ed is now taking in this information and his reaction is...
I would never try to hold you back and I'll support you, but as long as you're supporting this relationship.
Pretty decent result, actually. He said that he'll support her as long as she supports the relationship, which is not the most heinous thing to ask for. That's reasonable.
I mean, am I a little bothered?
Okay, when people ask questions and then answer them themselves. Am I a little bothered? Yes. Am I a little drunk? Yes. Would I kick Chef in the ass if you gave me the chance in an alleyway? You bet your life. But I'm happy for you. In fact, if you ask me how happy, I would probably say 10% equity.
But... so what? I mean, I would say go for it.
She did. She took it. I'm glad that you have a blessing.
I'm a little surprised at how supportive he's being right now. I was expecting him to throw a little hissy fit.
That sucks, asshole. The fact that you were expecting him to take it badly, that you got a raise and did something really well. Like, I understand the underlying implication that it's going to be more work hours and probably less time together. But again, you clearly love this man, and if you do, you shouldn't be afraid to tell him about your achievements and things like that. So it's sad that you even felt that he wouldn't be anything other than happy for you. But at least Big Ed came through and everyone's happy. So I'll give them a thumbs up for that one. Good job, guys.
Honestly, I'm going to be busting my ass off to bring home that extra money at the end of the month. And all that money I want to contribute into our future.
So then Liz says she wants to have that extra money contribute to their future, maybe get a house, do something stable so that they can have their relationship be some sort of foundation-like structure, you know? It's not just volatile, I would break up, move out. It's, we have a house, we have this together, we have equity, we have 10% equity, we have something that is ours, which is a good thing to do.
I think marriage has been weighing on my mind a lot.
Right now, I can't give you an answer on marriage. I'm not ready to marry anyone.
God damn it. And that is just the icing on the proverbial crap cake. They had two engagements, and still this 56-year-old man is like, well, I'm not ready. I guess if you're not ready, you're not ready. But God damn it, why would you have so many engagements? You're just a tease at this point.
Us getting married right now would literally be a contract for divorce with all the issues that we need to work through.
He's not even wrong. That's the sad part. This man probably making the right decision by saying, I need more time. It's just the fact that, my goodness, can they bolt it down and be like, well, if we're not going to get married, let's not get engaged. Because they're going to be engaged for 10, 20 years before they actually commit to marriage. And Big Ed's 56. He's not getting younger.
I know, but it is something that as I'm thinking about the future and now, like, wanting to be secure, not...
I am not going to be pressured into getting married.
Okay, so now Big Ed turns into a diva, and he's like, I'm not going to be pressured into getting married, bro. Okay? I don't know who brought that shit up, but I ain't ready for it.
To think or talk or anything like that.
I'm not ready. I don't feel like I'm being heard.
You are being heard.
I don't feel like I'm being heard.
Would you shut up?
I don't feel like I'm being heard.
Would you shut up?
Almost. They almost. It's a nice promotion, nice supporting thing. They talk about marriage. He says he doesn't feel like he's being heard. She's like, shut the hell up so I can hear you.
I'm just not ready to get married.
Oh, can you go back? Look at her face. She went like, she did the Jurassic Park on him.
I'm just not ready to get married.
I never seen Jurassic Park eye before. My goodness me. That is a first right there. Comment down below. Have you ever been Jurassic Park eyed before? Then she storms off and closes the door, yet again leaving them in a horrible position at the end of the series, because she is not happy that Big Ed decided he does not want to get married to her. Has he told her this? No. But he's doing it now, so. Good convo, guys.
I've dealt with a lot to stick by his side, and I don't deserve the drama anymore, I don't deserve the heartbreak, I don't deserve it anymore.
Yeah, look, it can get overwhelming. Liz is overwhelmed and Big Ed has made a very, very big decision right now. But I don't think that either of them should overreact, because Big Ed will change his mind. Clearly, he loves this woman. And she will probably calm down and be like, well, yeah, this bull is gonna marry me. So, I think it's just sort of blown out of proportion and Big Ed is unfortunately getting influenced by his mom again and not thinking clearly, because who else is he gonna get with at this point? He really does seem to love this woman, and she does love him back, for all that's worth. That is how the series ends. Big Ed doesn't want to get married. Would you believe it? We've been through another season of 90 Day Fiancé, and Big Ed is now the person telling other girls that he doesn't want to get married. We've come full circle, which is ironic for him. Can't believe that he would reject someone and say that he doesn't want to get married, but hey, this is how life works. But it's not over yet, because I do want to look at the next time.
Next time on 90 Day Fiancé, Happily Ever After, Tell All, No Limits.
Because I am very, very interested on the tell all. Usually someone loses their minds, screams at Big Ed or another contestant, and we have my favorite host of all time, Sean, who doesn't actually help anyone when anything is going on. She just looks there, smiles, and is like, okay! So I cannot wait to see what's going to happen.
An all-new 4-part series.
Do you like how she talks? Next time on 90 Day Fiancé, No Limits, all the people can suck my ass because they are going down in a blazing fire. It sounds like a robot programmed to talk like a human and has enthusiasm turned up to 200%.
Tell all. I call it the bloodbath. A crybaby.
Kiss my ass, dude.
Your
I want you to
try.
I want you to stop acting like a prima donna. Why do you keep coming back?
All right, so that seems to be what they've given us for the next episode. Just more fighting between these two goons. And boy, I'll tell you, I can't wait. This series is like the gift that keeps on taking. because I have lost years of my life keeping up with Big Ed. And this has been the season of Big Ed Watch. Thank you for sticking it out with me throughout the season. If you watch the whole season, you get a gold star. But it is not over yet. For the extra for experts, we have to watch the tell-all and see where these two end up. Because I am, of course, more invested in this than I am with the series. It's been a wonderful series. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you for taking the time to even join me with this. And hopefully you've learned something from this relationship. I don't mean what to do, but more what not to do, because this man is a walking contradiction. In a relationship like this, sometimes you just gotta watch it unfold and see what you can gain from it. I really, really do have hope for these two, but on the tell-all, I think they're gonna be arguing a lot, and I am here for it. Once again, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you for taking the time out. Can't wait to see you on the next one. Here's to a very, very happy new year, if I haven't already wished you. Take care of yourselves, and please, stay out of Big Ed's closet. He's probably lurking in there. Thank you. Amen.